And with us now, Dr. Samir Rafla, Emeritus of Professor of Cardiology, subspecialty of electrophysiology and arrhythmia. Hello, doctor. How are you?
You're welcome. And I am glad to be here. And our yearly conference, CardioAlex, is an international conference that has a very high reputation and value for teaching and for learning for both graduates and all people.
Okay. What do you think about CardioAlex? What's your first impression for CardioAlex this year?
Every year, all doctors, not only cardiologists, wait to attend this conference to learn in all specialties. Every year we have more than 70 international faculty. Beside our eminent Egyptian professors, they give top-class lectures, as if you learned European conference or American conference. So I enjoy it and I wait it every year.
Okay. What are you going to present this year?
My subspecialty is electrophysiology and arrhythmia. I like to give hint about a very important problem in the whole world and in Egypt, that is sudden cardiac death. Sudden cardiac death occurs not infrequent, and every person reads in the newspaper about a person who suddenly died at age not old. And we have to remind people and the doctors of the causes of sudden cardiac death. Number one is smoking. Smoking causes atherosclerosis, coronary narrowing, coronary spasm, and this can lead to sudden occlusion of the vessel and arrest. So 85% of sudden cardiac death is due to myocardial infarction. The other causes of sudden cardiac death is hypertension, leading to left ventricular hypertrophy. And hypertension and atherosclerosis causes are hereditary factors, hyperlipidemia, increased cholesterol and low-density lipoprotein, abdominal obesity, which is forgotten by some people as if it is not catastrophic, but it is really catastrophic. Abdominal obesity is catastrophic. Diabetes uncontrolled, and all this, and stress can lead to atherosclerosis, and atherosclerosis can lead to myocardial infarction and sudden death. Other causes of sudden death: pulmonary embolism, for coming from deep vein thrombosis. Other causes: electrophysiologic, hereditary channelopathies, like Brugada syndrome, prolonged QT syndrome, arrhythmogenic right ventricular dysplasia, hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. All these diseases can lead to sudden death. Now we go to how to diagnose it, how to prevent it. Prevention is by respecting any complaint. A patient got syncope, it must be well investigated, because first time syncope, second time is sudden death. We saw many times patients with, after getting sudden death, the family gives history, they had syncope before. The syncope was not respected, was not investigated well. Investigation include clinical examination, full history. History and examination is 50% of the whole armamentarium of reaching diagnosis. Then electrocardiogram, echocardiography, exercise ECG. These are basic investigations, and the next investigation is can do multi-slice CT, coronary angiography, and Holter monitor. Holter monitor, I have this apparatus. I can put it 48 hours over the heart to record, and if the patient gets his symptoms during these 48 hours, we can diagnose if it is due to sudden tachyarrhythmia or pause or complete heart block and so on.
Okay, thanks a lot, doctor. Really nice to see you this year. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Best wishes to all the audience.
Thank you.